We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of baseball on MLB Network. It's game two of the NLDS between the Colorado Rockies and the Chicago Cubs. David Dahl to the plate now, and we are set for baseball here this evening. The 3-1. And he lays off ball four, and the leadoff man is on to begin the ball game. Trevor Story steps in now. His matchup numbers with Hendricks. He's really struggled 0-for-10. Drilled to first. To second for one. To first, a double play. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up Charlie Blackmon. Two out, nobody on. 2-1.
Sitting in a good spot right here. Two ball, one strike count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
Called strike that time, and it's even at 2-2. Swinging a soft liner. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Here's Chris Bryant now. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now the 1-1 pitch. A ball and two strikes now. The 1-2. High and deep to left. This one's got plenty of distance. Into the bleachers and gone. In now, Anthony Rizzo. And there's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away.
Looks like that bomb earlier in the inning kind of put this pitcher on the defensive. Not being very aggressive right now.
Popped him up. Murphy is there. And that's the first out of the inning. So one away here with the bases empty. And into bat next, the versatile weapon, Javier Baez. Now the 3-2 pitch. Nasty breaking ball swung on in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Baez is retired. Two down now. Now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Kyle Schwarber, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Down low, two balls and a strike. Count even at 2-2. Comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Second inning set to go, and standing in is the veteran third baseman, Nolan Arenado. The 1-2. Hit hard back up the middle, and a diving effort there, but it'll come up empty. It's a base hit. Stepping in now, Daniel Murphy. Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. 2-2. Grounded to first. Rizzo is there. To second for one. On to first. And that's now two innings and two double play balls here tonight. Two away now. So base is empty now after the double play. And standing in is the veteran outfielder, Kevin Pillar. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Hayward on the run. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. Last half of the second set to go, and Wilson Contreras digs in at the plate. The 1-2 is laid off for ball two.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. At the plate, Jason Hayward, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. 1-1. High and deep down the left field line, and no one will get this one. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. You can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
The designated hitter, Cameron Maybach.
Too high that time, and it's 3-1.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
And that'll get down for a two-out single. Here's a look over to first, and he'll get back in safely. And another throw over. Throw is up the line as it gets away. At the plate, Ian Happ. There goes the runner. Pitches high. The throw. He's in there easily as the throw bounces on the way down. The set and the 2-1.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
3-1 pitch is a slider, and he can't pull the trigger. It's 3-2 now. And whoa, awfully close, but it's ball four according to Woody Keller. Striding in, Jason Kipnis. One ball and two strikes to count. Slider whiffed on for strike three. A great pitch to put an end to the inning. Top of the third set to get underway, and Ryan McMahon digs in to bat next. The 2-2. A little roller toward the hole. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. For the plate now is the designated hitter, Dom Nunez. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Swings through it for strike number two.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
Made a miss on the off-speed pitch that time. Dom Nunez goes down for out number two in the top half. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Still even at 2-2.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2. And a sinker called strike three as he's rung up and the side is retired. Bottom of the third now, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Chris Bryant. Yep. Wow, and he took something off of it there. It's 1-2. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out one way. Anthony Rizzo stands in now. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Now here's the pitch. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. And it's fouled away. Bases are empty, one man out. And He is in complete control now. Seven strikeouts as this is swung on and missed for the second out. Here's Javier Baez. First 2 men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. 2 balls and a strike to Javi Baez. This one's down to third. Gloved by Arenado. Throw to Murphy. He'll take care of him, and that'll end the inning. Digging in, David Dahl. He'll start things out against Kyle Hendricks as we get the inning underway. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. And this is going to get down out there and should get all the way to the ivy for extra bases. And he is into second base with a leadoff double.
Now back. Trevor Story.
Into the box now, Trevor Story.
No.
Too much dip on the sinker, laid off for a ball. Hit down the line at first. And it's a productive first out as that runner's able to advance 90 feet up to third here. Now at the plate, Charlie Blackmon, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. 1-1.
No.
Both teams with just 2 hits apiece thus far. To 2-2 now. Tried to fool him with the changeup, but he won't offer at it. 3-2.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's got to beat me.
And he misses with one here. It's ball four. So that'll at least bring the double play into the conversation with runners at the corners and one away. Takes this the other way to right. In there. Base hit. And that ought to get the run in from third.
Now batting. The first baseman.
To the plate now. Daniel Murphy down the first baseline. And Rizzo won't get to this one. It's a fair ball. And the runner from second is in to score.
The center fielder, number 11, Kevin.
Into the box, Kevin Pillar. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. 2 runs, 4 hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Rockies thus far. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
With one out and runners on the corners, some managers like to hit and run here. It's a little risky, but it can help you stay out of the double play if it's well executed.
Now the payoff pitch home. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And that's just shy of the baskets and off the ivy. And the runner from third crosses the plate. It's now 3-1. And he'll pull into second with one away.
Up next for Colorado, the second baseman, Ryan McMahon.
Standing in now, Ryan McMahon. Bouncer to the left side. Bryant's got it, and there's out number 2. In now for Colorado, Dom Nunez. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Murphy on third. Pillar at second with 2 gone. A ball and 2 strikes.
Even though it's early on in this one, anytime you get runners in scoring position, you'd like to knock them in.
And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact.
He certainly has an open base down there, but you don't want your defender standing flat-footed for much longer.
Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Bottom of the inning now, and next it'll be the left-handed power threat, Kyle Schwarber. Two and two.
Playing 2 balls, 2 strikes.
And he struck him out, and that's 8 strikeouts thus far. Next to hit will be Wilson Contreras, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see
if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
And he rings up another one. Make it 9 strikeouts for him in the game. So bases are empty here with 2 gone. And that will bring up the multi-gold glover, Jason Hayward. Counts even to Hayward, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Now a fastball inside, and he works it back to a full count now.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
The next 3-2. Now there's a swing by Hayward as he mashes this ball out to deep right field. Gone! Stepping in now, Cameron Maben. And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ball game, and the inning is over. All ready to go in the top of the 5th. And now it'll be the catcher, Tony Walters. And here's the 3-2 from him. And he takes a good swing at that one as this is sent down the line in right, but ultimately into the crowd, a foul ball. A swing and a ground ball to 3rd. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Tony finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at bat. And that'll bring up the speedy outfielder, David Dahl. I tried to backdoor him there, but it's a full count now, 3-2.
These last two guys are making him work quite a bit out there. Both have been long at bats, and all in all, he's had to make 13 throws just to them so far.
And there are 2 away now. Into the box now, Trevor Story. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here, similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
Into center field, line drive, base hit. So that'll extend the inning and keep it alive for Charlie Blackmon. So now to the plate, Charlie Blackmon. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. Now a throw over to 1st, and the runner back safely. The 2-1 pitch. And there he goes towards 2nd. Still 2-2. 5th inning of play here in a 3-2 ball game. Runner going a 2nd time. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed. And with that, the side is retired. Set now for the bottom of the 5th. And that will bring up the former 1st rounder and Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. High and deep down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. Here now the 2-2. Will not catch the zone. Ball 3.
You do not want to walk the 8-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt him over to 2nd with the 9-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. So the leadoff man reaches in their half of the 5th. At the plate now, Jason Kipnis. Now a curveball misses inside. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. On to Sheffield and gone. At the plate, Chris Bryant. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Fouled off. The 1-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. Now at the plate, Anthony Rizzo. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Ground ball right side, straight into the shift. McMahon's got it, and safe, says the first base umpire as the throw was too late. Into the box, Javier Baez. And awfully close, but it's ball four, according to Woody Keller. Peter Lambert takes the mound to try to get out of this mess. There are two on with only one away. Kyle Schwarber will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and one gone. The 1-1. And this one's in the dirt. Runners may have thought about it, but they'll stay put and the count moves to 2-1. From the belt, kicks and deals. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Fouled away.
Hey, last two pitches back to back, off speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
High chopper over to first. Onto the shortstop, but thrown away. And they won't come close to getting him. He's in there at third. Runners are at second and third here with only one away.
And stepping up to hit next, the catcher Wilson Contreras.
Now a ball pulled hard but fouled off to the left. The 1-2 gets him swinging. He struck him out. Here's Jason Hayward now. He comes in one for two with that home run he hit earlier.
Yeah, that last at bat, Danny, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile, but hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
Throw on to first, and an important pitch there as they get out of the inning before things explode. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring in Nolan Arenado. Now the 1-1 pitch. Is strike two swinging.
One ball, two strikes.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. The 1-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. Digging in and looking for more. Daniel Murphy, one for two on his line so far in the game. 1-2 now.
One ball, two strikes.
Protecting with two strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. Now he goes the other way, and he got a lot of it high and deep to left center field. And this will bang up against the wall. And he'll reach second now with one away.
The center field number 11, Kevin Pillar.
In now, Kevin Pillar. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Has a look, now the pitch. The 1-2 is a breaking ball. He can't find the zone, and it's even at two. Down the third baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number two. So a runner at second, two down now, and Ryan McMahon digs in to bat next. Now the 1-1 pitch. Line drive, base hit to right. And they're going to hold that runner at third base, as even with two away, they didn't like their chances there. Standing in now, Dom Nunez. Oh, right back to him on the mound. A on to first, and the Rockies fail to cash in as that ends the inning. Now it'll be the Cubs DH, Cameron Maven. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat. 1-1 is taken for ball two.
2-1.
Swing, and there it goes. Deep to left. No chance at bringing this one back. This one's into the bleachers and gone. To the plate now, Ian Happ. Pulled toward right center field. And he will make the catch while ranging backward as he just put the glove up and hauled it in for the first out. In is the second baseman, Jason Kipnis. One run in and one gone so far at the center. Hit in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. 2-2.
I don't know if that was a great take or he got fooled. He's certainly trying to play it off like he knew what was coming. You could bet he'd be on alert for that curveball again.
He froze him on the breaking ball that time. Jason Kipnis goes down for the second out here in the bottom half. And he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Hey, I got to commend him a little bit. Lead off homer, and now he's one pitch away from getting out of this inning.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Kyle Ryan is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 56.
Seventh inning ready to roll. And that brings up the catcher, Tony Walters. Ready with the 1-1. Hard hit toward the hole. And just past his outstretched glove into left, a base hit. At the plate now, David Dahl. And a check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he's set down for the first out. And that brings in the power hitting shortstop, Trevor Story. Last time through was a base hit. The 1-1 pitch. And here's a ball in the air now, carrying a bit out toward right center. Hayward has a read on it. Two gone. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And into bat next, the big-time RBI man, Charlie Blackmon. Now the 1-1 pitch. Here's a weakly hit fly ball off to the left side. And that's in there. Base hit. Dan Winkler trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away. So now to the plate, Nolan Arenado. Now a swing and a deep drive to left. And it ain't coming back. That one is out of here. This game is tied. Into the box now, Daniel Murphy. Way inside with that one. A pretty easy take there. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as this side is retired. Last half of the seventh here, and that brings in Anthony Rizzo. 1-1. Misses for the second ball.
Bobby Cox always used to say, I'm going to put you in positions to be successful. Well, against a modern-day bullpen, easier said than done. These guys are throwing flames from all arm angles.
And there's one down now. And that brings up Javi Baez. Six runs, seven hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. A ball and two strikes now. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
How about it?
The next Cub up, Kyle Schwarber, 0 for 3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. 2 and 2.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
Hit down the line at first, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2 and 2. Got him, and he goes down on strikes for the third time. Ready to begin the eighth, and that'll bring up a man who's a human highlight reel defensively, Kevin Pillar. The 2-2. He was laid off, and the count runs full.
It's a fine line for working down in the zone on 2-2 and bouncing one in there that basically stands no chance of getting swung at. Right there, he basically spiked that one right into the dirt, and now he has to find the zone on a 3-2 pitch.
Second baseman.
Stepping in, Ryan McMahon. It was a single for him in his last at-bat. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Swing and a ball yanked down the right field line. And Rizzo won't get to this one. It's a fair ball.
Now batter, designated hitter, Dom Nunez.
Stepping in now, Dom Nunez. And now a curveball as he's got to lean out of the way. That one nearly got him. And he fouls this one off. Ready with another 2-2. Nearly got the inside, but ruled the ball.
That's a good pitch to lay off right there, that cutter inside. And that is a real tough pitch for hitters to lay off of. And a lot of times, if you do swing at that cutter in, you're going to end up with some firewood and a broken bat.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Chopped in front of home plate. Throw in time at first for out number two. So with a left-handed hitter waiting, they'll go to their own left-hander out of the bullpen. Tony Walters will be his first assignment upon entering as he'll bat with the runner in scoring position here and two away. The set and the 2-2. And he lays off a pitch off the plate and high, 3-2. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and Wilson Contreras digs in at the plate. 1-1.
No.
Well, that'll wake everyone up. Anytime you buzz the tower like that, there's reason for people to start getting a little bit edgy.
Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter. Contreras swings, and this is well hit to left. Gone out onto Waveland Avenue. Yency Almonte is on the pitch here in the eighth with nobody out.
For Colorado, number 52, Yency Almonte.
Standing in now, Jason Hayward. With this one almost in books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-Roll, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
The 1-1 is swung on and missed for strike number two. Good plate discipline to lay off the slider that time, and he draws even a 2-2.
That was a nasty sweeping slider right there. If he was able to just catch the back door a little bit, he would have picked up that backwards K.
Murphy camps under it, and he's got it for out number two. And that'll bring in the Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. Rowan Wick takes the ball now in inning number nine, looking to close the door.
Number 50.
New inning set to get underway, and standing in the outfielder, David Dahl.
Hey, it's never easy scoring runs against a closer, but this lineup is setting up perfectly right now as the leadoff hitter leads off this inning.
Can't connect there. It's 2-2. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth. Digging in, Trevor Story. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Goes down and gets it as this is bounced to short. There's Baez on the first, and the Rockies are now down to their final out of the game. And that'll bring in Charlie Blackmon. One run game here in the top of the ninth. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. Good pitch as this is swung on and missed, and now they're down to perhaps their final strike of the evening.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That can be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
Last strike now for Colorado. Again, another foul ball. Hey, Chicago, what do you say? 41,118 on their feet here at Wrigley. And he gets strike three called to end it here. And with that, this one is over.
Hey, we were really treated to a good one today. Bottom of the eighth proved to be the difference, though. And a good job here in the ninth to close the book on this one.
Tight ball game all throughout. Winds up a slim one-run victory in the end as we get you one final look at our line score. Heroes are made in the postseason, and he was at least the hero in this one. He's our top player of the game.
And obviously, every game is so important in the postseason. So when you come to play like he did and make a big difference for your team, it's something that won't be forgotten.
A tight one, 7-6, the final score tonight. The Cubs earn the win and move on to 2-0 in the division series. Josh Osich takes home the win. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.
Here now is the final line score tonight. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. 7 runs, 8 hits, no errors. They left.